All right, let's continue on in the epic journey. Well, that was Ethan. Nice little spot for a little hide and seek action.
Ethan.
The little lord. Ain't he a fine chap? Let's see what he's made of.
I couldn't find him. Could you?
It's because I'm a boss, a pro hider. You ain't got nothing.
He hides too well, and if he were smart, he would reveal
himself. Not a chance.
I don't like this game anymore.
Forget it. Still a loss. Oh.
My only regret is I wasn't there to drive the dagger into his heart myself. I've been waiting for this day all my life.
Don't mess with me, buddy.
Get there, do you?
I may be young, but I'm not so easily fooled. You're trying to rile me, but it won't work.
Not a chance.
Young. You are that boy. Too young to know when you're in over your head.
No, sorry.
And no bread and salt. What kind of fucking house receives a charmer? Lord with no fucking
what
bread
a charmer.
And salt? You bloody amateur. No courtesies. I should have expected as much. Bloody Forrester.
Get over it.
Calm yourself, old man.
You little fuck! That's how you talk to a lord. You Forresters have shit on us for generations. Well, now the Starks are no longer around to have your back, are they? We're the power in the North now.
Roose Bolton is the Warden of the North.
Aye. And we've been his bannermen for 5 fucking centuries. You cunt.
Lord Ethan, you're losing control of this.
That's enough, Lord Whitehill.
I'm not finished. Maybe if you hadn't been so fucking greedy with the ironwood, things would have been different between us.
You squandered your share.
Our
share
was taken from us. We had no fucking choice but to harvest what was left.
What is it you want, Lord Whitehill?
Yeah, speak up. Oh, hey, I remember him.
Your man, the squire. We were minding our own business, keeping the king's peace, as his lordship here said, when your man attacked us for no reason.
Hear that? Attacked for no reason.
No reason? You murdered his family.
Then you admit it was your
man
who killed
he did
my
it.
Man.
What you gonna do about it?
And a pig farmer at that. How do you answer for your squire,
all right.
Lord Ethan? He acted in your name. And you are
let's turn it back. Turn
Lord
it back.
Of this house.
We lost people too, Lord Whitehill. Your men murdered his entire family.
You lost pig farmers, not soldiers. Soldiers worth 100 of their type. Where's the fucking coward who killed my men? I know he's here.
Yeah, what have you it's done a, it's him? All good.
I took care of it. He received his punishment and it's done.
It's handled.
It's gone.
What? Gone? That was my justice to deliver, boy,
shove it.
And you denied me of it. I'm not leaving.
Shove it, Buster.
My justice. Now bring me the coward who did it, or you'll answer to Roose Bolton. What kind of fucking house is this?
A house of honorable men.
Step back, Lady of the House.
Lady Forrester.
You bellow like a wounded boar, Lord Whitehill. Have you forgotten your manners?
I mean no disrespect to you, my lady, considering your losses and all. But this is not over.
It's over, Will.
And I say it's over.
This is over, Lord Whitehill.
Ethan is Lord of Ironwrath now. By rights, his word is law here. If that displeases you, then I trust you can find the door.
Snap!
That lad may be lord of this house, but Lord Bolton will have the final say. I'll send him a raven letting him know a Forrester man killed one of his own, that the new Lord Forrester lied to my face and denied me my justice. Then we'll see whose word is law.
Go ahead.
Do as you like, Lord Whitehill.
Yeah. You better walk away. Well, I went all right.
I was wrong about your son, my lady. He stood up to him like a true lord.
You were brave, my son. But you'll need to be braver still when Ramsay Snow arrives to see you
and
me.
Ramsay's a bit scary, I hear.
We need to send word to Mira in King's Landing at once.
Well, handled it. Take me to the action! Action!
Your sister can help us.
King's Landing.
Although just a handmaiden, she has Margery Tyrell's favor. And Lady Margery's betrothal to the king may be enough to keep the Boltons at bay. if it's presented to her as it should be.
She's a pretty sort, this mirror. All right, what are we looking for? Aha, letter. Let's have a read.
It troubles me to even ask this of you, but you must appeal to Lady Margery to intervene on our behalf.
Gotta make friends with Margery.
And can be a powerful ally, especially now when your family so desperately needs her help.
It's alright, we can get cozy with Margery. She's a nice gal. Who's at the door?
One moment.
Oh, sorry, m'lady. I didn't mean to disturb you.
He's mad at Dirty Sweat. If you'd like. Sure. You can come in.
No, it's fine. Come in.
What's his bag? He's got to change the piss. Oh, right. Coal boy. That explains the dirt. Of course.
Your pardon, m'lady, but you all right? If you don't mind my asking.
I've got nothing to say to you. Coal boy. You keep coaling.
Sorry, m'lady.
Yeah, that's right. You shouldn't have. Keep to yourself.
Please hurry if you can. Lady Margery will be here any minute.
Of course, m'lady. You work for Lady Margery? I may be wrong, but it seems like you do.
I'm her handmaiden.
That's what I thought.
What do you want, Callboy?
You seem like good friends.
What are you getting at?
I saw Lady Margery just this morning, outside the Royal Sept, talking to Queen Cersei.
Cersei?
Uh-oh. That doesn't sound good.
They appeared to be having some sort of disagreement. I couldn't hear
still,
much.
Still, what are you getting at?
It was definitely an argument.
Why are you telling me this?
I heard them arguing about House Forrester and...
House Forrester?
Ooh. It all hangs in the balance.
I thought you'd like to know. Forgive me if I was mistaken. I hope you're not in any kind of trouble. Most people don't tend to notice a coal boy. Not in King's Landing, with so many lords and ladies about. You see and hear all sorts of things.
Oh, yeah.
You don't even know you're there.
Might be a useful ally to have. Sneaky, sneaky coal boy. Alright. So, what's on the cards? What is Cersei planning? Oh, hello!
Lady Margery,
I'd recognize that face anywhere.
I was hoping there would be time for us to talk. Come, there's something we must discuss.
Don't deny it, you're all looking. Even the ladies.
From the day you arrived in Highgarden, I've thought of you more as a friend than as my handmaiden. A dear friend, in fact.
Love you too, sissy boo.
And you know how I feel about what's happened to your family. I feel your pain as if it were my own. What you've suffered is beyond imagining.
Gotta flatter a little bit.
Of course.
Better her up.
But you must not despair. We will get through this together. You must understand there are limits to what I can say. Especially here in King's Landing, now that I am to be queen. To have a handmaiden from the north whose family fought for Robb Stark.
Sticky spot.
It raises questions at a time I can least afford. Cersei herself cornered me this morning outside the Royal Sept. She mentioned the northern girl in my service, and she pointed you.
No, not me!
She was very pleased with herself.
How did you respond?
I told her you are one of my most trusted handmaidens, that you can hardly be blamed for the actions of your father and brother. Nonetheless, she demands an audience. She wants a
Margery.
Of some sort. For what?
You're a good sort. You're all right.
She's waiting for us now, and I promised I would bring you to her. I wouldn't ask this of you if it were not important.
Okay, gotta show some loyalty here.
Conflict with Cersei.
Gotta stick tight with Margery. We're gonna hang together.
My lady.
I knew I could trust you. Humor her. Tell her what she wants to
okay.
hear.
Okay, a little bit of humoring. A little bit of loyalty.
See if the Queen Regent is ready to receive us.
Remember, think of the house. The house first. And Margery. Margery will keep us alive.
You'll be fine. I know you will. You may feel one thing, but
okay.
you must say
feel
another.
One thing, say another.
Good luck.
Ready to roll. Man, Cersei's as scary as they come. Oh, hey, Tyrion. What's happening, buddy?
Lady Margery, aren't you looking lovely this evening?
Lord Tyrion, your grace? With your permission, allow me to introduce Lady Mira.
Hey, guys,
House
what's happening?
Forrester.
It's my moment in the spotlight. Let's see, we've got a kneel. Kneel to the Queen Regent.
Your grace.
All right, phew.
The girl knows her courtesies.
Hey,
impressive.
Why are you impressed?
When they rise.
All I did was kneel.
House Forrester is a northern house loyal to the king.
Are they?
I beg your pardon, your grace.
I wasn't talking to you. I want to hear from the girl. Is your family loyal to the king?
Perhaps you should ask the new Lord Forrester.
He's not here, is he? She is.
House Forrester's loyalty to the crown never wavers, your grace.
I see. And yet, for centuries the Forresters have been loyal bannermen to House Stark. A house of traitors.
Not traitors, wardens.
They were the wardens of the north. We all served at the pleasure of the king.
Clever girl.
Hey, got them both impressed so far.
Perhaps too clever for her.
Ah!
The girl did say their loyalty was unwavering.
She has a talent for equivocation, yet I question what she really thinks.
All right.
Is your house willing to swear fealty to your new liege lord, Roose Bolton?
Roose Bolton also served the Starks, your grace.
And proved his loyalty to the crown by bringing their house to a swift and sudden end. Old allegiances are not easily abandoned. But now that the war is over, we must look to rebuild and forge new alliances. There are ships and shields to be built, and Joffrey will need a steady supply of ironwood for his armies. I'm told there are others who would happily serve that purpose, but I trust we can rely on House Forrester.
Forrester Ironwood does seem rather unique.
I think so.
Yes, Your Grace.
I think so.
It would be a shame to see it fall into the hands of another house. I imagine you'd do almost anything to prevent that from happening, wouldn't you? Ask any Lannister, and they'd do whatever was necessary to save Casterly Rock. It would be unfortunate to see another house lay claim to what's yours.
I think so.
Yes, Your Grace.
I feel like I'm getting trapped. No?
I see.
What would you have the girl do, Cersei? It's not as if she fought beside the Starks, wielding a battle axe for the Northern Army.
Where is she going with this?
It raises an interesting question, I suppose. Can we truly blame those who end up on the wrong side of the war? Our dear Margery here was betrothed to Renly Baratheon on the assumption that
oh, that's dirty.
All the Seven Kingdoms. Can we fault her for her mistake? Should she be held accountable?
I won't judge her, Your Grace. I wasn't there. I didn't face her decisions.
A delightful girl. If only one could flit through life without ever holding an opinion of their own.
If there's a point to this, I hope you find it quickly.
Loyalty can be such a hard thing to define. This city alone is filled with all sorts of ambitious opportunists looking to reinvent themselves, pretending to be something
they're not.
Is that so? Who knows what lurks within their hearts? You are a girl from the north, here in service to Lady Margery. One can only assume her interests are yours. Yet loyalty to a king That must be absolute, beyond question. And if your loyalties were to become conflicted between your king and the very person whom you serve, what would you do then?
Oh no.
I'm sure she
would... Let the girl answer the question.
Go on.
I must choose Margery, Your Grace. I serve at her pleasure.
Clearly your handmaiden does not have her priorities straight.
She is a threat, isn't she? The most dangerous handmaiden
in
all of King's Landing.
I'm not quite sure what to make of her. Not surprising, I suppose, for a northern girl. But not very encouraging either.
Okay, so we got a mixed reaction. It's not a negative, but it's mixed,
like
alright.
I'd with you, if I may.
Okay, course, so that's fine, course. That's fine. Whew. That went okay. Could have gone better, but could have gone worse. Thanks,
I'll
Tyrion.
Walk you out.
Let's hang.
This may come as a surprise, but I met your father once at the tourney at Lannisport. Even then, he didn't trust Roose Bolton. We only spoke briefly, but your father struck me as an honorable man. You have my condolences for his loss. These would be trying times for your family, even under the best of circumstances.
Thank you, Lord Tyrion.
He's a kind man.
It's very kind of you to say.
You were brave to declare your loyalty to Lady Margery. No doubt she was pleased, but Cersei, she will not soon forget what you said. It was quite the first impression. I, of course, found it all highly entertaining.
Of course.
I did it for Lady Margery.
As you should. And of course she has your
Absolutely.
Best interests at heart.
Cersei
does. My sister and I have our differences. She takes great pleasure in her little charades. I take mine in thwarting them. We must find our amusements where we can. She threatened to give your ironwood to another house. It is the master of coin who decides.
Well, that's
such
a good
matters.
Thing.
The crown needs boats. Boats need wood, and I speak for the crown in this regard. Not her.
What are you suggesting?
I suppose the crown could be persuaded to secure ironwood from House Forrester. Lady Margery might not look favorably on such an alliance, and it would infuriate Cersei. Although what would be amusing for me might prove rather dangerous for you and your house. Are you willing to risk that? It may be far too dangerous. In fact,
I don't know. Whatever. Danger.
Thing.
Let's
risk
do it.
I need to take Lord Tyrion. Please.
You are a brave girl, aren't you? I'll consider it. Now, if you'll excuse me, I promised Sansa I would
Alliance.
Join her for dinner.
It must be good. It must be good.
Three beautiful bottles of Dornish wine await my arrival. The mere thought of them makes me thirsty already.
Oh, I didn't say anything. Oh, missed it.
Just be careful. This is not the North. King's Landing can be a nest of vipers to the enemy.
True that. Keep your guard up. Interesting. Interesting. Well, I hope foresters are in good stead. I hope. Everything is in motion and there's not much I can do about it. What is done is done.
Mira. I was worried. How was
Ezra?
It? Cersei has a way of looking at you as though you're nothing.
I think it's alright. I think it's okay.
Intimidating.
It went well.
Really? That's a relief. Cersei is known for being rather difficult.
Nah, she's a pussycat.
Lady Margery has spent the entire day working on seating
wow,
arrangements
fun.
For the wedding.
Jeez.
Of course, you and I are seated way at the back. Here with the fourth cousins and the ninth born sons. Ah, Sir Jamie. I wouldn't mind tarnishing that.
Good luck with that.
Of his.
Sarah?
What? It's true.
It's only good eyes for your sister.
Oberyn Martell. The Red Viper. I'm told he has a paramour. Which I doubt is Dornish for wife.
You'll get us in trouble.
We're just having some fun. Perhaps Lady Margery could make the right introductions. Who knows? We might meet
Ooh.
Our future husbands.
Some nice lowly lords.
Marrying a king? I can only imagine what that would be like. Would you marry Joffrey?
Oh,
if it
God.
Meant you'd become queen? He does have a certain look about him. And he's always treated Lady Margery well. Which is more than you can say for his mother.
I'd marry anyone.
Wow.
It helped my
family. That's quite a lot of loyalty there.
Right.
Jeez.
Of course.
Didn't know I had it in me.
Well, I would marry him. Imagine the power you would have as Queen of the Seven Kingdoms. I might even allow you to be my handmaiden. Let's see. Who else should
This girl's kind of annoying.
Brienne of Tarth and Tyrion Lannister. What a perfect match.
Be serious.
Sir Bronn and...
What are you doing?
Uh-ohs.
Well? Sarah?
I'm sorry, my lady.
As am I. We shouldn't have been messing about.
This is not a game. It's a battle plan. Allies and enemies can be made
Ooh.
With every move. Yet they say it is men who are powerful. The Queen was rather disappointed by your display, Mira. I'm just glad it's over. King's Landing can be exhausting sometimes. There's always someone to please or some perceived slight to smooth over. I fear it will only get worse when I am Queen.
Once they know your true heart, the lords and ladies will have no choice but to love you.
If only that were true.
Do you agree?
No.
People are not always so easy to please. If you showed Cersei your true heart, she would stab it with a fork.
Learn very quickly.
Yeah.
Your words to Cersei were brave, but I know you must fear what the Boltons might do to your family. I do appreciate your willingness to appease her, as difficult as it may have been.
You gonna help
Thank
out?
Thank you, my lady.
Gonna watch our backs?
There's been something on my mind. Something important.
Well, I gotta ask for help. I have to.
I did have a favor to ask of you in return.
Whatever you wish to say, you can say it in front of Sarah. There are no secrets between us.
It's about my family.
I trust her.
Oh, God. Well, Margery trusts her. Okay.
Go on. Ask.
Forgive me, my lady. I wouldn't otherwise ask this of you, but my mother insisted. It's about my family.
Ramsay Snow. What would you have me do?
My mother fears our family will suffer if Ramsay is left to do as he likes. She thought, if
he
a raven
a
could be sent to the Boltons
he
to let them know House Forrester has the protection of the crown. I know it's a lot to ask of you, and I wouldn't otherwise, but she insisted.
That is no small request. Especially now.
I know, my lady, and I wouldn't ask this of you otherwise, but my mother has left me no choice. She insisted.
Joffrey knows only too well your family fought for the Starks, and now you would have me ask him to intervene. Is the situation that dire?
You can't, my lady. King Joffrey won't like it. Just think how he turned on Lady Sansa.
I think, is it that dire?
It is that time, my lady.
I don't know.
I fear for my family's safety.
I'm sure the Foresters are tough, right? Ramsay Snow's a bastard, but the Foresters can hold their own, can't they?
I don't know, Mira. If
can't
Cersei
they?
Were to find out.
Don't let the Queen bully you.
Oh.
You have power over him, Lady Margery,
oh.
as no one else does.
Oh, she's a bit pushy. Bit aggressive.
Ramsay Snow will arrive at Ironwrath within the week. I would never ask this of you if it weren't so urgent.
So pushy.
Very well.
Wow.
I'll make your request, but I cannot promise
pushing
anything.
The future queen
Thank
like
you,
that,
lady.
That's intense.
I'll send a raven to my family at once.
I don't know if I would be that forward. Don't think so. Wow. Whew.